In the Bible, well, he says, you're going to have to flee. If you do what I tell you, I'll protect you. I will look after you. I will protect you. I'll protect your little children. I'll do all those things. I will do it. But you're going to have the faith to believe me. And when I raise up a work, believe it and get behind it and support it. And when I say flee, run for your life, because that's what it's all about. And that's when those European armies are surrounding Jerusalem. But God says, look, I don't care who you are, He'll protect you. He'll protect you, but this has to be serious. When you get into this, you have to say, do I really believe God, or do I just believe what people tell me? Do I really believe this to the point that I would run for my life when Christ said to? Think about that, because it's your future and it's mine. See, I can stand up here and blab all night, and if I don't believe and do this, I'm going to be a victim just like you are. Words don't impress God. Deeds do. Deeds do. Verse 22. For these be the days of vengeance, that all things which are written may be fulfilled. I mean, you can see a prophecy being fulfilled just about every week. All prophecy. Everything's being fulfilled today. Verse 23. And woe unto them that are with child, and lo, and to them that give suck in those days, for there shall be great distress in the land and wrath upon this people. So a lot of distress, it's just coming. That's the way it's going to be. And it's going to get, oh, so much worse. Verse 24, and they shall fall by the edge of the sword and shall be led away captive unto all nations. And Jerusalem shall be trodden down of the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. You see, there's a watershed change coming on the world. We're entering into the times of the Gentiles, and the times of Israel are over. God is not blessing America. He has in the past. He's blessed us like no other people on the earth. But how thankful are we for that? I can remember Mr. Armstrong saying in his prayer, the first thing he did in his prayer was thank God for all the blessings God had given him. Always he remembered to thank God first. I wonder how that stacks up with our spiritual lives. I think we could all probably improve there, couldn't we? But here's the big change that's coming. Not only is the beast power rising, but Russia and China, Venezuela, South America, all around us are rising. We're so deeply divided, you can't get anything done in America and Britain and Jerusalem today. I mean, that's how divided they are. More and more, you see the media and people like that saying they're hesitant and unsure about, well, how do you solve this? One of the commentators said recently, well, I just don't know what to say about that. I don't know how to solve that. That's right, and that's good, and that's wonderful. God is going to keep letting them go and go and go till finally they see they can't solve their problems. He tried to tell Adam and Eve that. And they said, oh, come on, we'll go out and we'll establish our... Well, they didn't say it that way, I'm sure, but they wanted to establish their education, their religions, their governments. God said, okay, go ahead. And here's the end result. Now the chickens are coming home to roost, as they say, and it's not a pretty sight. Well, verses 35 and 36, look at these beautiful words of God and Christ's own words. For as a snare shall it come upon all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth. Watch you therefore and pray always that you may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man. You have to be worthy for God to protect you, worthy to escape. We have to do something. We have to obey God's word. We have to obey God's law. Well, that's not popular today to obey the law, the Ten Commandments. You ask any minister friend you might have what sin is. I'll bet he can't tell you. What is sin? Well, he probably knows, but he won't tell you. 1 John 3 and verse 4 says sin is a transgression of the law. The law? Well, I thought that was done away. Well, Christ said in Matthew 5 and verse 17, think not that I came to destroy the law, but to fulfill it. Fill it up to the full, spiritually. Then he went on to say, well, before, if you committed adultery with a woman, that was a sin. Now, if you even look upon her to lust after her, then that is a sin. Or the same thing with hate and murder, and you know the scriptures, I think. But look, what is bad news about this? You're going to be able to stand before the Son of Man. Just stand right there, and there's God, and He's back, and you're standing before Him. Says in Daniel 12, verses 2 and 3, that you're going to shine like the stars forever and ever if you turn people to righteousness. See, there is a condition. It's conditional. You and I, you see, I have to get out and do what I can to turn people to God, or I'm not going to shine like a star forever and ever. And you have to find out where God's work is if you don't know, and back it and support it to the point that it turns people to God, or you're not going to shine like the stars and the brightness of the firmament. You're not going to do that. But think about what God is offering us. We're going to shine like the stars forever and ever and rule the whole universe forever and ever. And that's wonder. That fills you with wonder and joy and inspiration like nothing else could.
Request our two free booklets, Nahum and No Freedom Without Law. Our free booklet on Nahum shows that God will soon use a nation to correct the modern nations of biblical Israel. While this severe punishment is the worst time of suffering ever, it will cause Israel to return to God. It's also a sign that Jesus Christ is about to return to this earth. By turning to God today and supporting His work, you can be protected from this correction that is coming. Request our booklet on Nahum to learn more. Also, request our free booklet on No Freedom Without Law. This booklet shows how the founding fathers of the United States realized that personal liberty was dependent on private morality. They knew no nation could be truly free without obedience to God's law. Also, request a free subscription to the Trumpet magazine. This news magazine will keep you informed on how current events tie into Bible prophecy. You'll also receive more information about future personal appearance campaigns by Trumpet Editor-in-Chief Gerald Flurry. Request your free literature now. For the free literature, click on the Request Menu option. The preceding program and all literature were produced and sponsored by the Philadelphia Church of God.